Vishnu, one question before I move to the audience. What is the future? What are the trends emerging in healthcare? I think one of the ladies had asked this question in the morning as well.
The trends, one thing I would like to, what we are seeing, foreseeing in future in terms of technology is that, first of all, it'll healthcare, we have, so far we have been discussing a lot, whatever healthcare we talk about, it is like when you get sick, you go to a hospital and you get treated. That is where the healthcare starts. But now we are from that, we are moving to actually to an earlier stage where it is called preventive healthcare, where in it is very popular in countries of developed countries. But in India, it is still in a very early stage. But these technologies are actually bringing lot into the preventive healthcare, like your Fitbit gadgets. So where you are able to track, monitor yourself, and then if there is any abnormal readings or anything, you just go to a doctor and get, even before, because most doctor would actually agree, most of the cases when a doctor, when a patient sees a doctor, it is in the second stage or the third stage. So that is changing. So the future of technology will actually, once it should be into the preventive healthcare, where it will actually reduce a lot of time, because even the doctors are also very in short supply, because that will actually solve a lot of problem.
Sure.
And people also will be, it will save a lot of money also.
Sure, so preventive healthcare is the buzzword. I'll open the floor for questions. Raise your hands and we'll have the mics.
You always tell that innovation is going to reduce the healthcare, I mean the cost of the healthcare, but what I have seen so far is it actually increases the cost of the healthcare, because whenever there is an innovation, there is always a cost behind it, and it's an exception to rule, like Niramai like projects. So most of the thing is like that. So how are we going to make it right?
Sure, in case you didn't hear the first question, doctors being very conventional in their approach.
Right. See, it all depends on, you know, your basically mindset and where you get trained as. I'm talking about as a physician, I'm not talking about anything. Since I had an opportunity to go and work in the biggest center in healthcare, there each surgeon will have the two research fellow. His job is only to do things, to pick up things, then you'll have two engineers attached to each surgeon. So he will come to the operating theater every day. He'll come and ask the surgeon, hey doc, what do you think you can do? If this instrument is not working, you want me to change this angle? You want me to do this angle? So there is always an engineer along with, attached to a particular surgeon. Engineers, research people, innovation. All the products, whatever we are enjoying as of now, is all made by the human. When somebody at United States can think, why can't we think? Because we are only a consumer. We don't want to move ourselves to being innovators. Therefore, that you need to have a infrastructure that I think the government has to wake up. We are only 1% of the GDP is being spent for the healthcare, whereas 60% of the budget is allocated to the Kashmir for defense. Can you imagine where we are wasting our resources? Even though we are talking about GST, we are increasing so many things, but the government has to change their policy on healthcare. Can I ask you all one question? Which is the best country to live in the earth?
Norway.
Why? Why do you think Norway is? Somebody's answered correctly. Why do you think Norway is the best?
Because it's the happiness index is very high.
Before that, before the happiness index.
Crime is less?
No. Healthcare. That is why the quality is, I know, the country is one of the best country in the world to live is Norway, because of their healthcare. Healthcare, education, then everything comes blah 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 second. So we are there in somewhere in 100, 120 rank. So the government has to change its policy, has to fund. As madam said, if you're going to innovate something, sorry, I think I'm deviating a little bit out of this. If you're going to start some ideas to go innovate, you need to have a gestational period. For that, somebody has to support. Otherwise, how we are asking the entrepreneur to build for, you know, wait for no income, nothing, to wait for 3 years, 4 years. We are not a big country. So unless the government has changed the policy, hey, okay, we will support you for this. Usually when you apply for in the United States for new research, they will give. The grant is released by the United Nations government. So somebody can sit and relax, do 3 years, 4 years, come out of the good. So we are having a lot of basic problems. And again, coming to your questions, I think the mindset of our surgeon or whatever the physician, now almost everybody is going abroad, seeing the whole thing. I think the mindset of maybe the old time is difficult to change, but the younger generation are willing to change because we are seeing real difficulties of the poor patients. So we can definitely make a change.
So coming to your question, innovation is not necessarily always expensive. Or for example, I would state an example from our sector. We see a lot of discounts in medicines. Even we do also offer discounts. 3 to 5 years back, how many of you have seen medicine discounts of around 20% or 30%? This has started changing only after the technology started entering the space, wherein people, the market is so huge, you need only technology enables us to reach to the market. So now we operate on very low margin but to a larger audience. So that is where the technology will reduce the cost for everyone. And also when we talk about discounts, discounts are available in cities. When you go to a rural area, it is they don't find any discounts. Getting a medicine itself is a problem, it's a challenge for them. So that is where the technology again comes in, which will treat even the rural, remotest people living in the remotest part of the country also gets the same treatment as what people in cities also get. So that is where technology is playing a very important part. So even when you take about other industries like even Flipkart and Amazon, we started shopping in Amazon and Flipkart only because of the price reason. So only now it is actually evolving from discounts, price to convenience factor. Now the entire industry, e-commerce industry is moving from, it has evolved from discounts to convenience. So both these problems can be solved in one, the only solution for it is technology.
Please, okay.
Just small comment, sorry, I just finished this. So when you bring some new innovation, it's going to be costly initially. It has to spread out. Okay, initially, that is what I said, gestational period and the initial cost has to be supported by somebody. If you're bringing a new product, you have to wait for another, it has to be accepted by everybody. It may take a year or two. Once it's picked up, as you said, then cost will drastically come down. The more and more consumer, initially it will be high. But more and more consumers, it will get diluted. I think that's my example.
But the problem here is that, sir, the support has to come from the doctor. Then only the innovation can reach. Right. So that is the main
No, I'm Dr. Dinesh here. Sir, to you, to what you've said, I'm Dr. Dinesh. I'm a pediatric anesthetist. And I work with Dr. Vijay. So the thing is, when you say doctors are not cooperative, the thing is, in UK and US, there are they're only like, you know, 5 to 10 appointments per day. But here we do 10 times the work. We have no time. You have to find something to make us, you have to reach us. We can't reach people because we are really busy. I'm sure Dr. Vijay will agree on it.
Yeah, yeah.
When in the US they operate on 10 cases per day, we do 100 cases here. So that's the amount of workload that we do here. Yeah.
Yeah. Just to add,
so you
to
can't
that,
say that we are conservative. We just have no time. We are open to ideas. Come to us. Yes.
It's always a chicken and egg, and I believe entrepreneurs can break that vicious cycle.
Yeah. Just to add to that, right? Some of the meetings I had with the HCG HOD is when he's moving from one hospital to another. So I ask him, when are you moving? He says at 5 o'clock he goes to the other office. So I go with him in the taxi. That 1 hour. Bangalore, you know, it's a lot of traffic. That's the best part for us, right? We sit with him, do the discussion in the car. Then he can't operate anywhere, right? So you have to find innovative, but you have to find a person who is open to that. Yeah.
Again, you want to something to cultivate, you need to find a perfect soil. So identify the particular person. Okay, not everybody same. So identify the soil and then implant it will grow. So that is the key.
These are some deep words by Dr. Find the right soil. All right, we had one person.
Just to add to that, what you were talking, about after 2014, we are hearing about discounts in medicines, right? But we have a state in India where they prescribe only generic medicines, and the cost of generic medicines is almost 1/15th of the price actually that we give. So why is that the doctors don't prescribe generic medicines? That can be a better way of reducing the prices, cost of medication, right?
Is to me or the doctor?
No, I'm just asking you because I'm with the doctors only. Why? If the doctors can prescribe generic medicines, it'll be much more cost effective, right? Particularly in Rajasthan, in the state of Rajasthan, they've implemented and they've done it beautifully well. Even for the recent stealth that you're keeping for heart, when the government came out with the price, then everybody has accepted. So why is that the doctors are not shifting from prescribed medicines to the generic medicines? That will be much more cheaper and the cost will be dramatically reduced.
We as a technology provider, we are still not waiting for the doctors to write the prescriptions, generic prescriptions. We have already started offering, our technology platform is already started offering generic alternatives. You can find a lot of these medicines when you purchase medicines online, you can find generic alternatives when you type a medicine name. So that will actually be a part of it. In future, you will see a lot of this. The power is in your hands. You don't have to expect the doctor to.
That is the problem, right? You know, even if I go to the medical store today and I take a prescription, if the medical person there says this is an alternate medicine, you can use it. Say the people ask for the same medicine that has been given by the doctor.
Yeah.
That is the kind of mindset. Operating in this kind of mindset, if it is coming from the doctor, that's when it is driving. I can't go out to the net and find an alternative for that.
Point taken, point taken. Yes, sir.
Yes. So I got your point. I mean, I cannot speak for entire doctors in India, but in general, based on my experience, what I think, I'm sure everybody knows aspirin. Yep. Yeah? Right. When the same aspirin is given in the United States, I've operated so many patients on aspirin, they will bleed like a hell, because that is what we don't want, the blood to clot. So you can see the real effect. Whereas in India, aspirin made in one of our local companies, give them, there's not even any signs of whatsoever. So the sensitivity and its effectiveness is still questionable. Don't blame me. I'm not saying all the companies. So how effective are our medicines? That is where I said the quality and the standard has to come in. Because it's cheap doesn't mean like you can reduce the quantity or whatever the thing. So it should be cheap and it should be as good as Western medicine. Then only the doctor's mindset will move. But this is my own experience, but I'm not talking about others. Still, a lot of people do something different. I know that, you know, everybody's not the same. But what is, I've seen this aspirin, small tablets, maybe like 2 rupees. Again, I could see the difference in the effectiveness come from Western countries, come from our local companies. So that's my own experience.
So one last question before we wrap it up. One
last question. My question was in line with the previous question and the answer given by you, like you wanted to, you know, have a forum or innovation center involved by the government. So actually, I really appreciate that point, and if you can create such kind of forum where you can put in the problems, definitely there are so many engineering. For example, you give a problem, you throw a problem into Coimbatore, definitely we can give you a solution.
Right.
I'll just give you two examples. See, I was designing a microwave oven for Sanyo 10 years before. But today, I don't know how that connection had happened. I'm designing a product which uses microwave to kill a cancer cell, but it is a US company. And based on that, and another doctor from Kerala just casually had a chance to go and then meet him weeks ago. And he's a neurosurgeon. He was practicing in, he has multiple, you know, degrees in UK and US, and he's a neurosurgeon. So when I started talking to him, he said, all the doctors are using the ready-made machines that are available, equipments that are available, but definitely, now each equipment is not sufficient enough to handle every given problem. So he had listed me, like he was talking to me for about more than half an hour about what are all the helping needs that he needs from an engineering industry. I said, doctor, why don't you give me all these problems? All these problems can be
solved. Sir, I'm sorry, the question, let's get to the question. What's the question for the panelists?
So definitely, in addition to the innovation center, if you can create a forum for connecting the doctors and engineers, definitely that can lead to the next generation products, and that will help the medical industry, please.
A forum is missing, connecting the doctors. Yes. A social network for doctors.
Thank you.
Yeah, I mean, I agree. I mean, you know, as everybody talked about, we are very busy surgeon. If as an innovator or as engineering people, I mean, I can meet you after during lunch, so we can make it as a beginning. You know what I mean? We can make it as a beginning. Let's form a group and we can make a progress on out of it.
I know there are a lot of questions, but you'll be around for lunch. You feel free to talk to them offline. Parting remarks, healthcare plus innovation equals, give me one line on this.
As doctor, I would take the doctor's suggestion that the baby is still born, we are not in a marriage state yet. Because even the government also has to come a long way to do. Now they are talking about healthcare insurance, but only 10% of the population, less than 10% of the population are going to be insured. So affordable and accessible healthcare should be the motto of actually entrepreneurs, aspiring entrepreneurs also, I would urge, for the next decade at least. We have moved from other industries, lot of industries have come a long way, but healthcare is in a very early stage. So,
sure, healthcare plus innovation equals.
I think I agree with Mr. Vishnu. I think, you know, the make in India, you know, it's whatever it is started for a good reasons, but it has not grown up in a health industries. I think as an entrepreneur, you guys have to make it up. I know you are going to burn your fingers initially, but eventually you are going to make it there. So please put all your health, you know, whatever it is into the health industry. You can, as ma'am said, he said that you can, you know, make lot, get a lot of satisfaction apart from your money. So go for both.
Healthcare plus innovation.
Healthcare plus innovation, save more lives.
Sorry?
Save more lives, sir.
For the forum, whatever you are talking about, I am representing from BNI. So where there is a team in BNI, industrials are different discipline people are together. So whatever problem is there, whatever equipment you want or whatever idea you have, just put it across to BNI to reach us.
Okay.
We can all together engineer and give you a product in no time. We can promise from BNI.
Thank BNI you. Is going to your back to always support. Ma'am, I would want you to repeat what you said. Three very important words, technology plus healthcare is?
Saving more lives.
Saving more lives. She hit the nail on the head. Can we give them a big round of applause? As we kind of concluded that technology and healthcare, we are just born. They'll marry soon. But the most important question we have to ask ourselves is when will they deliver? Right, with that, a big round of applause to all the panelists.